Installing a fuse on a fuse holder seems simple enough, right? But I've just seen it done incorrectly enough times that it does warrant a dedicated video, and that's exactly what we're going to cover here in lesson number 4 of this Breakers, Fuses, and Overcurrent Protection playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Let's get started. How not to install fuses. The main problem that we see here at Explorist Life, whether it's with in-person electrical system checks at events or whether it's our email support inbox for shop.explorist.life, the biggest problem without a doubt is whenever somebody installs a fuse onto a fuse holder and then puts a washer and then puts their wire lug and then puts their lock washer and nut, tightens it all down, and they think they're good to go. The problem with this is that washer that's in between the fuse and the wire lug is not particularly electrically conductive and is going to introduce a ton of resistance into the system. And resistance into the system causes components to not work properly, but potentially more importantly, causes a lot of heat, and it can melt this wire, it can melt this fuse holder without the fuse ever blowing, and that's a huge problem. So the proper way to do this is to get that washer out of the way of the flow of power, fuse, wire lug, then the washer, lock washer, and nut. Tighten it all down with a wrench or a socket so that it's actually tight. And now power is coming through the fuse holder, through the fuse, and directly into the wire lug, then directly into the wire. And that washer is no longer in the way of the flow of power. So how do we install fuses? So the best way to install fuses, there's several different fuses that we have here, and so we're just gonna work down the line here. And we're gonna start with the MRBF fuse that we just showed. So the proper way to install this fuse and sort of look at how it works is, this is a MRBF fuse holder, and it's also known as a terminal fuse holder. And this typically is connected directly to a battery terminal in most Explorist Life systems, the starter battery, for DC to DC charging. And power is flowing through this metal, up through that metal. Fuse goes on here. This side is conductive. It goes onto the metal of the fuse holder. The filament of the fuse is inside. And then this ring of the fuse is on top and is conductive. Then the wire lug goes on top, then our washer, lock washer, and then our nut. And it's tightened down with a socket or a wrench to the manufacturer's recommended torque spec, and that is good to go. So power is flowing through this metal, through the fuse, through the wire lug, and out through the wire. And the washer is not in the way of the flow of power. Another option for MRBF fuse holders is a dual MRBF fuse holder. And I'm not gonna wire all this together because it's pretty easy to see how that works. If you look at this one, it's just a copy paste of this one. So this would be connected to a battery terminal. And then that power is going through this metal entirely here. And you would put one fuse here and one fuse here. And then you could put a wire on this one and a wire on this one. But the biggest thing to remember is don't put that washer in the way of the flow of power. So how do we install an ANL fuse? So an ANL fuse gets an ANL fuse holder. It's a big beefy fuse holder that's going to handle just a lot of amps. And here's how to install this onto this. We're going to uninstall all of the nuts on the fuse holder. And this particular fuse holder has a washer on the inside, two nuts for the fuse holder space. And now we have these two copper bars with these four studs. The fuse goes in place like so. The washers go on top of the fuse. The nuts go on top of the washer. These get tightened down with a socket or a wrench. And you'll notice that the flow of power through the fuse is in direct contact with the copper bar, with no washer in the way of the flow of power. The wire is going to be connected to this end. Another would be connected to this end in the same fashion. And then this nut would be put on this side and tightened down a tool, and the same for the outgoing wire. Now, this fuse holder and fuse, it's not directional, so it sort of doesn't matter which direction the power is flowing through this whole assembly. The most important thing to understand is that all of these need to be tightened with a wrench or socket, and that the washer is not in the way of the flow of power. How do we install a mega fuse? So we use mega fuses in our explorist.life electrical systems, and there are mega fuse holders, like individual ones similar to that, but we don't use any of those. More commonly, we're installing a mega fuse in a fused bus bar situation like the Lynx distributor, which is simply a positive and negative bus bar with four fuse holder spaces inside. And here's how you would connect a fuse to a Lynx distributor like this. We would take the nuts, lock washers, and washers off of each of the fuse holder spaces. And note that we would leave this bottom nut in place because that's what the fuse sits on top of. That nut there is not in the flow of power though, as you'll see in just a second. The mega fuse is then going to go on top of those studs like so. And then the wire is going to go onto the top of the fuse like so. And then the washer is going to go on top of that. And then the lock washer is going to go on top of that. And then the nuts are going to go on top of that. And these would be tightened down with a socket or a wrench. And then power is coming in on that positive bus bar there directly into the fuse, and then from the fuse directly into the wire lug, and then out from the wire. And you'll notice that there is no washer in the way of the flow of power of this circuit. How to install a MIDI fuse. So a MIDI fuse is realistically just a smaller mega fuse or smaller ANL fuse, and is installed in much the same way. But, you know, MIDI fuse holders, you can sometimes find them, but typically we see them installed as part of a larger distribution system like the Blue Sea safety hub here, where power is coming in from the battery into this terminal, and then is being distributed through this bus bar here, and then these screws, and then power is going out through these terminals here. And in this case, you know, your conductive surface is that bus bar at the back, and then that piece of metal in the very back there. You would just undo these screws, make sure that all the washers come with the screws, put the fuse in place, and then put your screws back in place, ensuring that there are no washers in the way of the flow of power for this device. And you can kind of see that the MIDI fuses are already in place there on the inside of this Blue Sea Safety Hub 150. So how to install a blade fuse. So blade fuses are these really typical fuses that you see in most automotive applications. And you know, there's fuse holders for all of these. So this is a blade fuse, and this is just an inline blade fuse holder where you would cut this wire wherever you needed it to and connect one side to like a bus bar, for example, connect the other side going to or from whatever component that the other side is connected to. But to install the blade fuse, there's just two little slots down inside of that fuse holder right there. And then the two little blades of the blade fuse just go into those slots. And then you just push this until it's all the way in there. Another option for blade fuses would be something like that Blue Sea safety hub like I just talked about. There's spots for 5 or 6 blade fuses in there, and power is coming in here, and it is powering one side of the blade fuse holders here, and power is going out through the wires that are coming from this terminal here. And you can see this system in use in the Explore mini systems that we have on our store. And to install this blade fuse, you simply put it into its spot and push. And it's hard to do that and show it on camera at the same time. And you just push and it just clicks into place. Just simple. Same as in your car. With a fuse holder like this, you know, you don't really have to worry about washers getting into the way of the flow of power because we don't use washers with this. You know, you still have to pay attention to not putting washers in the way of the flow of power with a device like the safety hub or any of the other devices similar to this that you may run across. But that washer is actually not going to be where the fuse is installed, but where the screw terminal would be here on the top. And there is a little serrated washer there on that screw. I'm not even gonna hold it up because it's really, really small. I just have to take my word for it, but that would have to come off and that would go on top of the wire lug when all that gets connected together so that the washer is not in the way of the fuse of power. The washer is not in the way of the flow of power. How to install a PV fuse. We've already covered PV connectors in a previous lesson in this academy, and these are popular for connecting solar panels to a charge controller. And if you need a PV fuse for your solar array, then it's going to be connected usually to a branch circuit combiner, a PV branch circuit combiner. And these are really simple to install. They simply connect to the branch circuit combiner like so. And then the other end gets connected to the other PV connector, like so. And your PV fuse is installed. The fuse is inside, but they come like this, so there's really nothing to do. There's no washers to worry about. This one's probably the easiest one to install out of this whole bunch. So that pretty much covers all of the typical fuses and fuse holders that you see in systems on shop.explorist.life. So let's switch gears a little bit and talk about breakers. How to install a DC breaker. So here is our typical DC breaker. We don't use these in very many circuits, but we do use this in a couple of them, specifically alternator charging. It works pretty well up under the hood for that particular circuit. And there's really not a lot that can go wrong with these for the most part, because on this particular breaker, there's really not a washer. There's a captive, I don't even know what that's called. It's a captive washer, let's just call it that. But there's really no way that that can get in the way of the flow of power. So the wire gets connected here directly to the stud here and the conductive surface underneath. And then that nut just secures the wire in place on there. And there's no way to sort of like mess up that flow of power on this particular one. But if you run across a breaker that does have a washer, your lug would go on top, and then your washer would go on top, and then your nut would go on top of that to keep the washer out of the way of the flow of power. That would be incoming power, and then the outgoing power would have the exact same thing happen on that side as well. How to install AC breakers. AC breakers also don't include any kind of washers to sort of mess up, but an AC breaker in a typical RV style breaker box, it has this little slot on the back of it here and this little hook on the bottom of it here. The hook goes onto this little rail at the bottom and the back. And then that slot just presses up and onto one of these bars here at the back here, like so. It snaps into place. This would be the main breaker where power is coming in, and it would get connected down underneath to that little screw terminal underneath there. And for a tandem breaker like this, it's going to be installed in the breaker box in the exact same manner, with the hooks over the bar on the bottom and pressed into place like that. And then you just have two screw terminals on the bottom of that where the wire is going to go into that and the screw terminal is going to be tightened down. Now there's really no way to sort of mess that up from a getting a washer in the way of the flow of power, as there's no washers in that. So that one's pretty easy for the most part. Most people don't mess that up. So as a recap, I feel like I've been repetitive enough for you guys to understand that the most common problem that we have with installation of fuses and such is getting the washer in the way of the flow of power from fuse to wire terminal. That's the absolute biggest problem we have. The second biggest problem we have is not tightening all this stuff properly. I mean, you don't want over tighten it so much that you're stripping out any of the threads and stuff like that, but it does need to be tightened with a wrench or a socket. So those are the two problems that we have with overheating of fuses and fuse holders, that the fuse cannot effectively disconnect the flow of power because there's not actually a lot of power flowing. It's just simply too much resistance and therefore overheating. So now that we've sort of outlined the problems with fuse holders and how to fix those problems by properly installing fuses onto fuse holders, we're going to move on to the next video, which I don't remember what it is. We're going to move on to the next video where we're going to cover how to choose the correct size of fuse for your system. So click up here to watch and I'll see you over there. Reiterate. Oh my gosh. Washer is not in the way of the fuse of power. The washer is not in the way of the flow of power.
The fuse of power.
Let me get my two hobbits and then we're going to go on this quest to find this fuse. The fuse of power. One ring to rule them all.